Ever wonder what it takes to keep your BMW X3 running smoothly? Today we are diving into the heart of your vehicle's drivetrain to tackle a critical maintenance task, replacing the transfer case fluid. While this job is DIY friendly and can be done right in your own garage, there are three major obstacles you will need to overcome. Are you ready to get under the car and discover the rewards? Welcome to Professor's Garage. Thank you for stopping by. If you found this video to be helpful, please leave us a like. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. There is much more to come on DIY mechanic tips and tutorials in the garage. Back to the job. I purchased this 2017 BMW X3 M Sport at over 82,000 miles recently. It's overdue for fluid replacement on the drivetrain. So there will be a series of videos on transfer case, rear and front differentials, and automatic transmission fluid change. Today we'll focus on the transfer case fluid replacement, and I will show you every step in this job to overcome three major challenges for this maintenance, plus one important practical tip at the end. Let's get started. Engage the parking brake. Raise the front of the car as well. Put a couple of jack stands in the front for additional support. Make sure the vehicle is level when you do your fluid check. Double check the car is stable and safe. The transfer case is right here, but there is no drain plug. This is our first challenge. It does have a fill plug and we are going to suck transfer case fluid from there. To do this, get a fluid extractor or syringe and make an adapter for it. Simply heat up the middle of the tube and bend it like so. Connect it to the extractor tube and you are ready to join, so to speak, the fluid. Need to remove this driver's side undercover to gain better access. We need to access this side of the bracket, and as long as we can get this off, it should be good. Yeah, ooh. That hopefully gives us enough clearance. Now, we have another major obstacle. The bracket is in the way, and we need to remove it first to get access to the fuel plug. Before you remove the bracket, you need something to support the transfer case. So here I use a floor jack with a piece of wood. So 16 millimeter socket on this side, 18 millimeter on the other side. So this one you need an extension. And then the other side you don't need an extension. It's kind of a shallow socket. We're going to try to break loose. This is the nut on the other side. Ah, finally. 2 16 millimeter on the driver's side. So now be careful, because once we remove it, it's going to fall down. Yep. This is on the other side of the bracket. Remove the last bolt. This whole thing will come off. Okay, great. Okay. Now we have access to the fuel plug. Let's take it off. Make sure it's seated. Good. No fluid coming out. Mate.
Let's suck the fluid out. It's dark. Put a catch pan under it. So in the end, I got about 550, 560 cc.
So this is the transfer case for it. Now it starts to overflow. It's full.
So that's exactly 600 mil. New fuel plug. Torque it to 60 newton meter or 44 foot pounds. Great.
Your transfer case is full of fresh fluid. Now it's time to reinstall the bracket. Something really important here. During this job, the transfer case should be supported without the bracket and make sure it doesn't move. If it does, raise it back to its original place so you can tighten the bolts. In my case, it actually moved and came down a little bit, so I had to pump the floor jack to push it up before I can easily feed the bolts and thread them back on. Also, never use power tools to thread the bolts, or you may dig into a bigger trouble.
Now torque them to 19 newton meter or 14 foot pounds. The driver side for the 16 millimeter bolts, so 19 newton meter or 14 foot pounds. Yes. And now back to the passenger side. And this transfer case is not going anywhere.
Now, before you can drive it, there is one more step, our third challenge. The transfer case needs to relearn or calibrate with the new fluid, or your next rides may be interesting. Yes. Welcome to the BMW world. Fortunately, my latest scanner, the Kimberling K6, has that feature. So let's give it a try.
On this Kimberling K6, under BMW and special reset functions, there is a transfer box calibration. This is what we need after the replacement of the transfer case fluid. So let's redo the calibration.
Lots of warnings. This is scary.
It says it has been recalibrated. The new calibration value has been stored in the VTG control unit. Continue. Continue. So let's restart the car to see what it says. Looks like everything is back to normal.
I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If a professor can do it, crawling under the car, you can do it too. Be safe, stay dirty. Until next time, may the Lord bless you, and may His peace be with you. 平安.